wish you could make it rain over the garden or turn down the heat on a blistering day. So much of our lives can hinge on a weather forecast. It has the power to cancel an event or even destroy livelihoods and natural wonders like the Great Barrier Reef. So what if we could control it? Since day dot, people have been trying to predict and influence the seasons. There have been rain dances, rituals, and prayers to the weather gods. And the idea of making it rain over drought-stricken farms has seen some big money go into the wrong pockets.
There's a real history of snake oil salesmen out there, people promising they can make it rain with no scientific basis.
But amongst all the snake oil, Australia's been home to two notable rainmaking projects where the science stacks up, in Tasmania and in the New South Wales snowy region. Snowy Hydro's cloud seeding program says it's been able to increase rain or snow by 14% over the colder months. It works like this. Minute particles of silver iodide are added to a cloud, creating ice-like particles, which then produce rain or snowflakes. So why can't we just do that when we have a drought or a bushfire?
It only is done in very, very special circumstances. You have to have a very special condition called supercooled liquid water. That's clouds with water below freezing that remains as liquid and not turned into ice.
Meaning the clouds and climate over most parts of Australia are not ideal. And when it comes to putting out a bushfire, there's a whole different hurdle because where there's fire, there's smoke.
It's very polluted air coming out of the bushfires, obviously. I would say that, you know, a lot of countries just don't see the physical premise for this working.
So while smoke is a problem, could the sea offer a solution? On Australia's Great Barrier Reef, an ambitious pilot project is underway right now. They're pumping seawater into the sky so that small particles of sea spray drift up into the clouds above, helping to reflect sunlight.
It only uses around 30 millilitres of water a second, and from that it creates 3 gazillion droplets per second. And so that's just a shot glass of water creating gazillions of droplets.
They're using the ocean to try to save the ocean. How? By brightening the clouds with those tiny droplets. It should cool the marine environment below over the warmer months. The hope is to stop further coral bleaching and allow damaged parts of the reef to recover.
Okay, well then you're changing the clouds. What might that do to the local weather?
The thing is, we don't know yet, which is why this program is being closely watched. But scientists in other parts of the world have gone bigger. Some have even tried to change the path of hurricanes. So where do you draw the line? What if we make it rain? Is that taking rain from somewhere else that needed it? And what if it rains too much and floods? Who's to blame then?
We really are not smart enough to know what the long-term effect of it is.
So while science might offer part of the solution, it's not the silver bullet for the climate mess that's largely human-made.
I think people and governments will use it as an excuse not to, you know, do something about carbon emissions and to try to clean up the earth as much as possible.
So can we control the weather? Well, it turns out, yes, we can. But that power doesn't just rest in the hands of a few. There's 7.6 billion of us in the control room.